Hi everybody, thanks for coming back to 1MinuteDigital.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make this very simple rope design element. It's not an illustrated rope by any means, it's just a very simple way to make a rope element using the brushes palette in Illustrator. It's used a lot in nautical design or to make kind of weird looking badges like this one that I'm working on for another tutorial. We're not going to make this whole badge today, I'm going to show you just how to make this one rope element that you can use for a badge or for a flyer or whatever you want. Okay, let's make a new artboard. And I need you to have a few things showing before we get started by going to Window, Brushes, that brings up your Brushes palette, and Window, Pathfinder. Have those two things showing, and also go to View, Smart Guides, and make sure your Smart Guides are turned on. That's going to help you with this tutorial. Now go over to your toolbar. It defaults to Rectangle Tool. Choose Rounded Rectangle Tool, and click anywhere on your artboard, and it doesn't matter what the width and height are, just make sure the corner radius is at 0.25 inches, and say OK. Delete that, and then click and drag a nice minion-shaped little guy for our rope segment. Make it a black stroke with no fill. And then on your toolbar, with that selected, find the shear tool. It defaults to the scale tool. Find that shape, click and hold till you get the shear tool. Now click anywhere inside there and just drag it a little bit to the right, and that makes it lean a little bit to one side. And there we have our rope segment. Now, clicking away from it, hold down Shift and Option, click and drag. Leave a little bit of space between them, and then hold down Command and the letter D and do that two times. Now you have four rope segments. Now selecting all of them, go to Object, Compound Path, Make, or Command 8. That makes them one shape. Now I'm going to zoom in a little bit, and we need to make sure at this point that our rulers are showing. By going to Command R, and you see that brings up your rulers, or go to View Rulers. Now click on your ruler on the left hand side. Actually, first select everything. Then click your ruler and bring it over to a path where it says anchor, and then let it go. You can see that ruler is there, zooming in. What we're going to do is make a guide on this anchor point. We're going to skip one segment and put the next guide on the exact same anchor point on the fourth shape. So click on your ruler and drag and put it in the exact same spot there. Now find your rectangle tool, the real one, or the first one. Select, or rather click and drag on the top of your elements on that guide. Click and drag to the second guide that we made. Let go, and now make that a invisible shape by getting rid of the stroke and fill. So now it's there, but it's just invisible. Now select everything and go to Object, Clipping Mask, Make, or Command 7. And that gets rid of the rest of that for our swatch. But if we hover over it, you can see that those things are still there. So selecting everything, now go to that Pathfinder that we opened up, and the third one under Shape Modes is Intersect. Click there, and now if we hover over it, you can see that those are gone. It is just this little part for our swatch. So now select it, click and drag it over into our Brushes palette, choose Pattern Brush, OK. Bring the scale down to anywhere from 10 to 15%. Choose Colorization Tints, OK. Now if we zoom out a little bit, move our swatch over, and if we select an ellipse, hold down Shift, click and drag. Let me get rid of the guides here. And make that a stroke with no fill. And now if we click on our brushes that we just made, our pattern brush, we see our nice rope is now in that circle. This works for any shape that you use. You can use the pencil tool and draw a squiggly line. Choose that, and it makes a nice rope. You can use the rounded rectangle and make a square or a rectangle. Choose your brush, and there you go. It doesn't work on the regular rectangle, because if you do that, it's going to ask you to come up with the corners for it, which you have to actually make, and that's for another tutorial. So if you're looking to have a graphic with a rope around it, like on your flyer, just choose rounded rectangle, and that will come out okay. You can also, remember when we made our little minion guy with our rounded rectangle? You can experiment by drawing your own shapes using the pen tool and repeating the steps that we just did, but maybe make your own shape to make your rope. And you'll have lots of very customized different rope brushes. that you can use for all manner of things. So it's a really fun tool to play with, and you get some really very simple results. I hope that was easy, fun, and helpful for you. So until next time, bye-bye.